Sa video natin ngayon, sasagutan natin yung problem na to na recently lumabas sa board exam sa November 2024 na examination. Now, we have a fully restrained beam and then we are to solve the beam reactions. Then second is the location of the maximum deflection measured from the left end and also the value of the maximum deflection. Now, meron tayong formula para sa fixed end moments sa beam na to. But what if nakalimutan mo? Now, yung ituturo ko na method ngayon is solving the reactions using the three-moment equation. And then, ipapakita ko na lang mamaya kung ano yung derived formula. And then, let's try to compare kung tama ba yung masasolve natin. Sige, so, yung approach natin dito, since we have a fully restrained beam, then we would have to add imaginary spans. Kasi yan yung kailangan natin kapag merong fixed end. Kapag if you will use the three-moment equation tapos merong fixed end, then you would have to use imaginary spans. Now, dalawang fixed end, so dalawang imaginary spans din. So, let me draw an imaginary span dito and also on the other side. Ayan. Now, this would be my point 1. Ito yung point 2 ko. Yung location talaga ng support, then point 3 saka point 4. Now, we are interested in establishing points on the same level or same elevation lahat para yung value ng H1, H3, H2 saka H4 magiging 0 silang lahat kasi walang distance from the endpoints to the middle point sa 3 points mo, sa 3-moment equation. So, this would be 0, saka ito rin, and then, basically, lahat ng h magiging 0. Kasi lahat ng points natin are on the same level. And then, since imaginary span to, this would be L3. Let's say, span from point 1 to 2, this is L1. From point 2 to 3, this would be our L2. So, this is L3. Now, L1 and L3, nasa imaginary spans yan sila. Therefore, all the terms containing L3 or L1, it would just become 0. Or neglect mo na lang yan. So, ito, meron siyang L1. This would be 0. Saka, ito, M3, L2. Walang L3 saka L1. So, it would just remain. But, M4 times L3, magiging ano rin yan, 0, kasi nasa imaginary span na siya. And then yung factors natin, let's try to check for point 1, 2, 3, this would be the first span, ito naman yung second span. Now, diba, this factor is for the first span, ito naman for the second span. Basta merong barred A, first span, barred B naman para sa second span na yan. Now, for point 1, 2, 3, the first span is an imaginary span. Therefore, this will just become 0. Ayan. And then, para sa point 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, this would be the first span. And then, this would be the second span. So, L3 would correspond to 0 pala. So, ito, magiging 0 din yan. Kasi L3, diba, second span para sa 0.234. So, wala kang factor dyan. So, what would remain? Magiging 2M2 na lang, then times L1 plus L2 plus M3 L2, then plus the factor for barred B. So, barred B2 divided by L2. Then equals 0 kasi diba 0 times 6EI magiging 0 lang din. And then for the second equation, first equation natin to, for the second equation we have M2 L2, so M2 L2 plus, kopyahin na lang natin lahat ng matitira, L2 plus L3, and then plus 6A1 barred A1 divided by L2. equate din natin to 0. So this would be our second equation. Ayan. Now medyo madali na lang since M2 and M3 yan na lang yung unknowns natin. L1, L2 saka yung factors natin meron kasi silang numerical values. So for the first equation we have 2M2 unknown yan. Then L1, what is L1? L1 is on the imaginary span. Therefore, this is equal to 0. So parang 0 plus L2 which is 6. Then plus M3 L2, our M3 is still unknown. Then L2 is still 6. Then plus 6 A2 barred B2 over L2. Now, sa previous discussion natin, I already discussed how to use this formula to solve any type of loading. But for now, since na-discuss na natin to, how you can use this one, ito na lang yung ituturo ko, yung merong factor na talaga. Ito na lang. Now, you can try it yourself na lang using the concentrated load anywhere on the span in conjunction with integral calculus. Try it yourself and then compare the answers. Dapat same lang sila. So, again na, nasa previous video natin yan. And then, i-add ko na lang yung 6A barred B over L. So, 7 na lang, 7 WL cubed divided by 60. So, we have 7. Ano yung W natin? W is 10 kilonewton per meter. So, 7 times 10. And then, our length is 6. So, times 6 and then naka-cube yan divided by 60. So, equate mo lang to 0. And then, for our second equation, we would have M2 times L2. What is L2? L2 is 6. So, times 6. Then, plus 2M3. Then, L2 is 6. L3 naman is imaginary. So, plus 0, essentially. Then, plus, yung kailangan na natin is barred A1 kasi yung span 2 to 3, first span na yan para sa 0.234. Bale, ito, this is for 0.123. And then, this is for 0.234 naman. Kasi diba, tatlong points talaga yung kailangan mo kasi 3-moment equation. 3 points yung kailangan. So, gagamitin natin is ito na kasi barred A na yung kailangan natin. So, 8 times 10, then L is 6 pa rin. Cube natin, then divide by 60. Equate to 0. So, meron na tayong 2 equations. Now, we can simplify this one. The first equation simplifies into 2 times 6 magiging 12. So, 12M2 plus 6M3. Then, to apply our calculator technique for two equations, two unknowns, just move this one to the other side of the equation. So, this would be negative. And then, change mo lang yung sign and then copy mo na lang to. And then, our second equation would be 6M2, this one, and then 2 times 6 magiging 12. So, 12M3 equals, lipat na lang natin sa kabilang side ng equation, this would be minus this expression. Ayan. And then, input na lang natin sa calculator. So, go to mode, then equation, two unknowns. Then, input the coefficients of M2 and M3. This will be your X, and then ito naman yung Y, according to the arrangement. So, 12, 6, then negative 7 times 10 times 6 cubed divided by 60. And then we have 6, then 12, tapos negative 8 times 10 times 6 cubed, then divided by 60. So negative 288. So ito na yung labels natin. I mean, values. So, press equals. Ito na yung value ng M2. M2 is equal to negative 12 kilonewton meter, and then M3 naman is negative 18. Kilonewton meter. Yan. So, we can now copy this one, our original beam. And then, let's try to make sense of the values here. Now, M2, again, kapag meron kang nag-apply ka ng three moment equation, tapos meron kang fixed, dalawang fixed ends, then yung value nito, since negative yan, it would just mean that the reaction here is also counterclockwise. Bale, this would be 12 kilonewton meter. Now, I will just label this as A, and then ito naman B. So, this is the moment reaction at A. Yan, 12 kilonewton meter counterclockwise kasi negative. But, magbabago siya kapag dito ka na sa right side. Kasi yung value kasi na makukuha mo dito would be the value sa moment diagram mo. Yan. So, dito sa point B, negative 18 siya, but hindi ibig sabihin yan na counterclockwise din yung rotation sa B. Again ha, dito yan magbabago. Kapag meron kang fixed end sa pinaka-right side, then the reaction here would be opposite to what you will get sa M3. Therefore, the reaction here is actually clockwise. Then 18 kilonewton meter. Ito lang yung dapat mong you have to be careful with this one. Kasi dito usually nagkakamali yung mga students. Kasi dito, negative 12, so counterclockwise. But dito naman, negative 18. But this is considering parang negative effect ng beam sa bending niya. So yung pasad phase na configuration or puff round. So kaya, this is acting clockwise. Or, para maklarify na lang talaga, diba, M2 and M3 are negative. Negative yung values nila. So, parang negative effect ng bending. So, diba, puff round. So, this would be counterclockwise. Ito naman, clockwise. Now, kapag positive yung makukuha mo, positive naman yung effect. Pasmiley. Na para ma-form yan, then we would have to have a clockwise rotation here and a counterclockwise rotation dito to form this type of bending. Parang ito lang yan. Parang end moments kasi yan. So, negative effect, counterclockwise, then clockwise right here. And so, generally, for positive bending or the smile effect, the moment at the left end is clockwise and the moment at the right end is counterclockwise kapag positive yung value na makukuha mo sa three moment equation. However, kapag negative bending or frown effect, then counterclockwise yung moment mo sa left end, then clockwise at the right end kapag negative yung values na makukuha mo sa three moment equation. So yan generally yung dapat mong i-follow. Sige, so alam na natin yung moment reactions. So isosolve na natin yung vertical reactions. Diba, we have AY, we also have BY. Yan. Now, magmo-moment na lang ako sa point B to obtain AY. So, summation of moments about B, we have AY multiplied by a moment arm of 6. And then the rotation it will cause is clockwise, so kaya positive. Then we have 12 kilonewton meter, this is counterclockwise. So, minus 12. Huwag mo na i-multiply by a moment arm kasi moment na yan. Diba, pag i-multiply mo siya by 6 meters, magiging K and M squared na yung unit. Which is sa slope na yan. And then, merong resultant reaction. I mean, resultant load yung triangular load natin. So, this would be the area of the triangle. Which is 1 half times the base multiplied by the height, 10. So, this would give us 30 kilonewtons. And then, the moment arm going to point B which is nasa matabang side ng triangle, this is 1/3 of the base. So 1/3 multiplied by 6, which is equal to 2 meters. And then the rotation it will cause is counterclockwise pa rin. So minus 30 load times moment arm. So multiplied by 2. And then equate to 0, I mean not yet, meron pa palang 18. Kasi kasali pa rin yan kapag nasa point B ka. Moment load kasi yan. Yung BY, hindi nakasali kasi wala siyang rotation na makukos about point B. So we have plus 18. Kasi clockwise yan. Then equate to 0, let's solve AY. So AY times 6, then minus 12 minus 30 times 2, then plus 18. Equate mo yan to 0. So we have 9. AY is equal to 9. Ayan. And then, summing of forces vertical, we can obtain BY. So, AY plus BY, ito lahat ng upward forces natin, equate natin sa downward force. So, equals 30. Now, AY is known, BY is unknown, and then equals 30. So, BY equals 30 minus 9, we have 21 kilonewtons. Equate mo na lang yan. Yan, 21 kilonewtons. So, meron na tayong mga sagot para sa number 1. Solve the beam reactions. By the way, this is MB pala. And so, apat na values yung kailangan natin. Dalawang moment reactions, then dalawang vertical reactions. So, dito naman tayo sa number 2. What is the location of the maximum deflection measured from the left end? So, yung pinaka-ideal na way is by double integration na lang. Bakit ideal siya? Now, usually, kapag location of maximum deflection yung kailangan mo, DIM is advised. And then, yung maganda dito is, you have boundary conditions dito sa point A. Fixed support yan, therefore, the value of the slope and deflection here is equal to 0. Now, kapag 0 yan sa left end, automatic C1 and C2 sa double integration or your arbitrary constants, magiging 0 lang din sila. So, kaya, mas madali siya sa double integration. Sige, so, let's try to form the moment equation, which is defined by EI y prime prime. Ayan. Now, our origin of x is from the left up to a cut made just right before the last point of the last segment. Now, since we only have one segment, let's try to make a cut right here. The last point is at B, so somewhere to the left of B. So, this would be X. Ayan. So, mag-moment tayo sa cut. Yan yung gagawin natin para sa moment equation. So, we would have 9KN then multiplied by X, moment arm niya. Yan yung moment na makukos niya about the cut. Then, positive kasi clockwise yung ikot. Diba? Pag ganyan. Pag ito yung hahawakan natin. And then, we have 12 kilonewton meter counterclockwise. So, minus 12. But take note, dito usually nagkakamali yung mga students, nakakalimutan nila yung times x to the 0. Kasi diba, yung moment natin, meron siyang influence sa slope mamaya. But, wala siyang influence dito sa moment kasi diba, minus 12 is just a constant value sa moment equation mo. Kasi this is a moment load. But x to the 0 is just equal to 1. So, minus 12 times 1, negative 12 lang din yan. But it will matter sa slope sa deflection natin. So, we have to add an exponent of 0. And then minus, we have 1 half times base times height x, and then our height is h over b to the n times x to the n. Now, the height of the triangle is 10, the base is 6, and then times x to the n. Now, n here, saka dito, would just be equal to 1 since we have a triangular load where the degree is 1. So, pwede mo nang hindi na siya isulat. And then, the moment arm is x divided by 3. Ayan. And then, ito lang yung loadings natin. Hindi na kasali yung 18 kilonewton meter kasi nasa right side na siya ng cut natin. Hindi na siya kasali. Now, para ma-explain ko lang to, na-discuss na kasi natin yan sa previous video din natin sa double integration. Parang ito yung ginawa natin. Let's say this is y, this is x. And then, our whole triangle is, it has a height of 10. And then, the whole base is 6. Ayan. So, by ratio and proportion, we have y is to x for the smaller triangle. And then, for the bigger triangle, we have 10 is to 6. Therefore, y equals, this will simplify into 5/3. Divide mo lang yung by 2, yung numerator saka denominator. So, ito yung value ng y. Now, for this particular triangle, yan, let's say this is a cut. Since x is a variable distance, then our resultant would be equal to the area of the triangle, which is 1 half times x multiplied by y. But y must be in terms of x. So, itong value na to, isa-substitute natin sa y. And then, the moment arm is x divided by 3. Or 1/3 of the base. Yan, 1/3 niyan is x divided by 3. So, itong finorm natin, this would correspond to the load 1 half times x multiplied by y, which is this one, 5/3 of x. The same lang yan sa 10 over 6. And then, this corresponds to the moment arm, x divided by 3. So, load times moment arm pa rin yan. And then, kanina, yung in-apply ko is our shortcut kasi, which is height of the triangle or any type of spandrel divided by the base to the nth power multiplied by x to the n. So, if the load is a spandrel load which has a degree of 2, then you will have to substitute 2 sa n. Yan lang yung considerations mo. Now, we can further simplify this one. We have EIY prime prime equals 9x minus 12x. By the way, ha, you cannot join the terms right here. Yan, even if same degree sila, dapat separate per loading. And then, again, this becomes 5 divided by 3. So, 2 times 3, 6 times 3, magiging 18. So, minus 5 divided by 18. And then, tatlong x, isa, dalawa, tatlo, so x cubed. Ayan. Ito na yung moment equation natin. So, integrate once, makukuha na natin yung slope equation. So, we have EI y prime. Yan, para to sa slope. This would be 9x squared divided by 2. Dagdag ng 1 sa exponent, then divide the expression by the new exponent. Then, minus 12x, dagdag ng 1. So, 0 plus 1, magiging 1 yan. Then, divided by 1. Or pwede rin na, huwag na lang natin isulat. Then, minus 5 over 18, x, plus 1 sa 3, magiging 4. And then, divide by 4, multiply mo na lang yung denominator by 4. Ayan. Then since merong nag-integrate tayo, then merong lalabas na arbitrary constant. Sabihin natin C1. Then integrating once more, we have the deflection equation, which is EIY. So this would be 9x to the 4th, cube pala, plus 1 sa 2 is 3, then divided by 2 multiplied by 3. Yan. Then minus 12x squared tapos divided by 2. Then minus 5x, dagdag ng 1 magiging 5. Then divided by 18 times 4, then multiplied by the new exponent 5. Then itong C1, meron na yung kadugtong na x. Then we have a new arbitrary constant since nag-integrate tayo dalawang beses. However, since our boundary conditions would occur sa support at A for which the slope and deflection is 0, are 0 pala. So, at x equals 0, the slope is 0 kasi walang slope kapag nakakantiliver siya. And then, at x equals 0 pa rin, at A, walang deflection kasi merong support. Now, kapag ito yung boundary conditions mo, at x equals 0, slope is 0, then deflection is 0, automatic yan na C1 and C2 will become 0. Kasi diba, the value of C1 is the slope at the left end. And then the value of C2 is the deflection at the left end. Now, kapag 0 yung dalawa, walang value sila. So, ito na yung gagamitin natin. And then, take note that the maximum deflection occurs where the slope is 0. So, galing yan sa maxima minima natin sa calculus. So, for the location of the maximum deflection, we have to set the slope to 0. Ayan. So, 0 na yan. And then, yung C1, wala, hindi na yan kasama kasi magiging 0 lang din siya. And then, input natin yung expression sa calculator. So, we have 0 equals 9x squared divided by 2 minus 12x, then minus 5x to the 4th divided by 18 times 4. Now, shift solve, maglagay ka ng value ng x na realistic kasi diba, naka x to the 4 yan, merong apat na roots. So, we have to consider the realistic one. Now, looking at the figure, the larger load is located dito. Kasi diba, triangular load, mas malaki yung values ng load dito. So, our maximum deflection would is likely to occur from, let's say, 4 meters to this point, yung pinakadulo. Or, it would be, let's say, from 3 na lang, from 3 meters to 6 meters, or gitna na lang ng 6. Yan yung pinaka-safe na estimate. So, input na lang ako ng value dito, which is half of the span, so 3, equals, we have 3.1481704 6. So, ito na yung location ng maximum deflection. Sulat na lang natin up to the last decimal. 1481704 6. Ayan. So, store ko na lang to sa letter A. Nakameter pala yan. So, ito na yung sagot natin para sa number 2. Now, using this value, we can actually derive an expression for the maximum deflection in terms of L. Now, this is only applicable para sa same loading lang din. Kapag meron kang triangular load over the whole span of a fixed-ended beam or fully restrained beam. So, what if iti-treat ko to as L, yung 6? Yan. And then, itong value ng X, diba, ito yung location ng maximum deflection. So, diba, we would have L times a certain coefficient this would be equal to the maximum deflection. Ito yung ratio niya. So, yung L natin is, di ba, 6. And then, what is A? A is unknown. Then, equate ko siya to X, which is 3.1481704 6. Therefore, the value of A is equal to ano na lang, A divided by 6. Yan yung value ng A. So A is equal to 0.5246950766. Yan. And so, from the first equation, the value of the maximum deflection would be L multiplied by A. Or essentially, ito na lang. Kopyahin na lang natin yung first 4 decimal places. Or first 5, kung kaya mo siyang i-memorize. So, this would be 0.524... And then, 7 na lang. 4 decimal places na lang kasi 9 na kasi yan. So, pwede mong gamitin to to approximate the location. Now, you may choose to solve this one using variables talaga. Like, let's say, gawin mo tong W and then gawin mo tong L. But it will be tedious sa simplification na part. So usually, when deriving an expression for generalized equations, yung ginagawa ko is nag-ratio and proportion na lang ako. And then apply mo, parang yung A kasi parang yan yung constant of proportionality. So ganyan lang din yung concept dito. So 0.5247 times the length, yan yung location ng maximum deflection from the left. So kapag yung tanong is from the right, then 1 minus 1L minus 0.5247L yung magiging formula mo. But medyo intuitive na yan siya, but baka sa time nyo yung tatanungin is from the right, so medyo dapat careful ka dyan. Sige, so alam na natin yung value ng maximum deflection. So isosolve na natin yung maximum deflection, yung value niya. Na walang EI na binigay, so ititreat na lang natin siya as constant. So bali yung sagot natin for the maximum deflection must be divided by EI. Parang ganun. So ito yung equation natin sa deflection. Diba? So we have to substitute here the value of X for which the deflection is maximum. So this would be EIY equals, diba, lahat ng X natin 3.148 naka-store sa letter A. So yung ilalagay ko na lang sa calculator is this expression, but I will have to substitute the value of A. So EIY is equal to, equate natin yan, we have 9x cubed, or pwede mong gawin na lang A and then cube divided by 2 times 3, 6 yan. Then minus 12 divided by 2, magiging 6. 6x squared, so 6a squared. Then minus 5 times a to the 5 divided by 18 times 4 multiplied by 5. So press equals, we have negative 16.9586506. Now up to the last decimal na lang yung gagawin natin. 9586506. Now, the unit is KNM cube. Kasi nasa deflection na kasi tayo. Diba, moment is, again na, reiterate ko, moment is kilonewton meter. Mag-integrate ka in terms of X, it will become KNM squared. Kasi diba, yung distance yung ini-integrate natin. Then sa deflection, magiging cube na siya. KNM cubed. Dagdag ka ng degree every time you integrate. Kaya KNM cubed yung kadugtong nito. Yan. Or any unit of force times a unit of distance na naka-cube. So, pwede yan maging pound, foot cube, or newton, mm cube, mga ganun. So, describing y, divide mo lang by EI yung dalawang sides. So, this one, then divided by EI. Now, the negative sign only means that the deflection is downward. So, ito na yung maximum deflection natin. Now, what if you want to memorize a certain formula para sa maximum deflection? How can you derive an expression from the value we have obtained? Ito yung gagawin mo. Notice na yung K and M cube, yan yung default unit, di ba, sa expression na to. Therefore, the deflection is directly proportional to this one. K and M cube, yung value na naka K and M cube. Now, what provides a value of K and M cube? Kung W yung binigay. Diba, this is a distributed load. So, kapag distributed load, then you would have WL to the fourth. Kasi diba, unit ng W is KN per M. Then L to the fourth, that would be M to the fourth. So, magka-cancel yan. Cube na lang yung matitira. So, this is KN M cube. Therefore, we have to use this expression para sa proportionality. Now, kapag hindi distributed load yung binigay, let's say hindi uniform load or hindi triangular load, then you will have to use PL cube. Kasi yung unit ng P is already kilonewtons. Then multiply mo by L cube, magiging M cube essentially. Ayan. So use this one para sa proportionality mo. Then just solve the proportionality constant. So we would have y is equal to y is inversely proportional to EI. Diba? Kasi yung EI, you have to divide this sa kabilang side ng equation. So this would be parang WL to the fourth divided by EI directly proportional, inversely proportional times the proportionality constant. So we are now combining this with topic sa MSTC, diba? Sa algebra man to. And then, this would be y equals this expression. So, isusolve natin yung k, or the constant of proportionality. Lagay ko na lang ah. Now, to solve k, gagamitin natin yung values na nakuha natin. So, w is, for our figure, W is equal to 10. And then L is equal to 6. So at W equals 10 and L equal to 6, the maximum deflection is this value. Now, just take the absolute value na lang. Alam naman natin na downward yung magiging deflection. So copy mo na lang to. And then we have Y equals, palitan na lang natin this value. And then equals W, which is 10 times 6 to the 4th, L to the 4th, divided by EI. Then multiplied by K. Now, since EI is constant, pwede mo siyang i-treat na lang as 1 para ma-solve mo yung K. So, we would have 16.958.6506 equals 10 times 6 to the 4th multiplied by k. Again, treat this as 1 na lang yung EI. So, solving k, we have 1.3085378, which is 0.0013 0853785. Now, isulat na lang natin yung up to the last decimal place talaga. 0.0013 0853785. Yan. Therefore, our equation, general equation, would be the maximum deflection is equal to 0.0013 this value. Now, mahirap i-memorize yan. yung buong up to the last decimal place talaga. So you can just memorize the first four decimals and then approximation na lang yung gagawin mo. So 0.0013 times WL to the 4th divided by EI, ito yung maximum deflection natin, formula niya. However, I don't encourage memorizing talaga, memorizing formulas. Mas maganda pag alam mo yung basics, kasi kahit nakalimutan mo yung formula, you will have a backup plan para sa board exam. But if bata ka sa pag-memorize, then why not memorize this one para makasave ka ng oras. But again, depende na yan sa preference mo or learning style. Now, i-check down natin. Dito tayo sa deflection light. So, kailangan 100 yan, saka ito naman 10 million. Para yung makuhang value natin sa deflection would be in terms of K and M cubed divided by EI. So, yung loading natin is, wait lang, palitan ko lang to. So, dito tayo sa start talaga. 6 meters yung span, and then the uniform load is 10 kilonewton per meter. So, 0 and then 10. Ayan. So, notice, the maximum deflection is negative 16.958649, which is the same lang sa nakuha natin. Ayan, 16.95865. And then, the location is somewhere around 3.1 and 3.2 pag i-move natin siya. Ayan. So, between 3.1 and 3.2, yung value na nakuha natin kanina is 3.14817046, which is realistic lang. Ito, location ng maximum deflection. Now, what if gagamitin natin yung equation na na-derive natin? This one. Let's try to change the beam. Yung value ng, yung location ng maximum deflection, hindi yan mag-change. Kasi same lang yung loading kasi natin. Kapag meron kang triangular load over the whole span, you can always apply this formula. Tingnan natin. So, tatanggalin ko to. And then, let's try to make the span equal to 9 meter. Yan, fixed-ended. And then, ibahin natin yung load. So, let's say from 0 up to, let's say 15. Ayan. From 0 to 15. Now, let's try to check the location of the maximum deflection. So, here, the location of the maximum deflection is between 4.7 and 4.8. So, para ma-approximate mo yan, kasi meron namang choices sa board exam, then you can use this formula we have derived. So, 0.5247 of the length daw. Input daw natin. Store ko to ha sa B. Yan, yung value nito. Ito. Naka-store sa B. Lagay ko na lang. So, again, dito tayo. We have between 4.8 and 4.7. So, the location of the maximum deflection is 0.5247. Ano yung length? The length is 9 meters na. Nag-iba na yan kanina. So, times 9. So, 4.7223. Notice na, this is just between, anong tawag dito? Between 4.8 and 4.7. So, our estimate is medyo malapit lang sa actual value talaga. So, kung merong choices and then alam mo yung estimate mo, madali na lang siya. And then, the value of the maximum deflection is minus 128.77974. Now, kapag merong choices, again ha, this is in terms of K and M cubed over EI. Naging MM lang yan kasi sinat natin yung E saka I to 110 million para makuha natin yung numerical value nito. So, 128.77974. Now, our generalized equation or formula is 0.0013 WL to the fourth divided by EI. So, we have 0.0013 times, ano yung W? W is 15, diba? So, times 15, then our L is 9 meters. So, WL to the fourth, then divided by EI. Now, just treat this one as 1. So, press equals, we have 127.9395, which is malapit lang sa value natin dito, 128.779. Now, medyo may discrepancy lang kasi yung ginamit natin na decimal places, 4 decimal places lang kasi. But, if we are to use the exact value talaga, diba, this value is nakastore sa letter B. So, kapag papalitan ko to by B, and hindi ko siya gagamitan ng 4 decimal places lang, then yung makuha ko na value is 128.7797, which is the same lang dito. Diba? Yan. So, hindi ko siya i-advise na i-memorize mo talaga, but at least know the, at least itong 4 decimal places lang, and then para meron kang approximate na value kapag merong choices. But again, mas maganda pag alam mo yung basics talaga. Pag alam mo yung basics, hindi mo na kailangan i-memorize to, saka ito, kasi masusolve mo by yourself na lang. Sige, so again ha, yung kinumbay natin ngayon is the concept of proportionality and also structural theory. So, medyo may pisad sa MSTC sa discussion natin ngayon. So, yan lang yung dapat mong tandaan talaga. So, I hope meron kayong natutunan, and then let's hope na lalabas to ulit sa next board exam kasi may masasagot na kayo. Meron na kayong mga bonus points. Sige, so, yun lang. Salamat sa pagkikinig. Thank you.